So here we go. This is the first introduction and my first attempt at doing a YouTube video. So what I'm doing this week is a video diary on a Lake Beauregard in France. As you can see, I've got the van loaded up here. Need to shut my garage and get off. I'm travelling from Manchester to Wellingborough to pick up a load of bait, and then from Wellingborough to Milton Keynes to meet my mates Pete and Will. We're getting the van loaded up and then setting off at about 2 o'clock in the morning. The next update I'll give you is when I get to Milton Keynes and get to Pete's to get the van loaded up. So sorry for the short introduction, but I'm running 20 minutes late. Catch up with you later. Cheers. So here we go. Second update of the video diary. Just arrived in Milton Keynes at my friend Pete's house about 2:30. Pretty good journey down. Went and picked up the boilies from XL Baits. I'll tell you a bit more about them as the week goes on. Van's still fully loaded up, so plan for the rest of the day. Get my van unloaded, put all the stuff into Pete's van. Gonna go out tonight, have some tea at the pub, and then we'll be up at early hours of the morning, off down to Dover. Lake that we're going to is Lake Beauregard. It's about junction 21 off the A26 in France, I think, about 240 miles. I've fished there twice, 2011 and 2013. I've had a few different 40s out of it, quite a few different 30s. Some cracking fish to go out there. It's a lovely lake. Just done about 10 different 50s so far this year in the middle of March when it opened, and 2 different 65 common, so it'll be good to get amongst them. But if I don't, it's a week's fishing with my mates, so which is what it's all about for me. So this is my first video diary that I've done, and really what it's about is just about giving you an insight into my fishing, what the other lads sort of have been up to. Some of them, you know, I've never met before, so it'd be good to chat to them and find a bit more about what they do with their fishing. And like I said, I'll show you some pictures of the lakes and show you the facilities, hopefully some fish, and then if it's a lake that you're going to or someone that you fancy going to in the future, then you might get a bit more information. And also, the other thing I wanted to mention was that I recently set up a Twitter account and a Facebook page and a YouTube account called Carp Bible. Got up to about 2,000 followers so far in the last 5 weeks of setting it up, so it's going quite well. And that purely is just like a networking option for people to talk about carp fishing, and not just about rigs and new rods and the best bait and all that. It's for people to share information about why they got into carp fishing, their favourite swims, food that they like to cook on the bank, and everything that makes carp fishing for me, spending time with your friends, your family, on your own, and obviously chasing the prizes that we all go for. So I'm going to turn off now, wait for Pete to get back, unload all the stuff, and then I'll give you another update later on, maybe when we get down to Dover in the morning, but if not, it'll be when we get to the lake and we're doing the walk around before we do the draw. Cheers. So here we go. This is the next update on the Lake Beauregard video diary that I was going to do this week. So traveled down yesterday, got to the lake, had a little wander around, did the draw. I came out 6 out of 6 as usual. That's my 7th draw I've done in the last sort of 7 years, and come out six times, so I'm sort of destined to get it really, but it's nothing new to me, so I don't mind. Yeah, so everyone picked their pegs and I've ended up on peg 1, which I was quite pleased about really. It'd have been my certainly in my top 2 choices if I'd have come out higher in the order anyway, so I was quite pleased about that. Put the rods out yesterday, didn't really do a great deal of feature finding or putting bait in or what have you. It's first day, and you know, you're normally pretty knackered after the drive down, so stuck the rods out. No joy for me last night. As far as the rest of the lake goes, one of the lads had a small catfish, and then Pete, the lad I travelled down with, he had 2 fish. He had a little 10-pound mirror. That's spoke to Roger this morning. He said there's only like 1 or 2 of them in there, and they're sort of for future growth. And then he had a 32-pound 4-ounce mirror as well last night, so this was pretty good for the first night. There was a bit of frost this morning when we got up, so it's fairly chilly last night anyway. So the plan for the rest of the day is to go and get showered, get sorted out. I've already had breakfast, and then I'm going to have a wander around, chat to the other lads, and then get back, put some time into finding me spots, get a bit of bait in. Peg 1, I've fished in this peg before, and I did okay out of it. Generally what happens with this peg is though that the fish will turn up part way through the week for a couple of days. They don't tend to stay in here for the full sort of the full week duration, so we'll have to make the most of the fish when they move in, and then potentially I'm gonna have to move into peg 12 if the fish move with it. So I'll catch up and I'll check in with you later on. Cheers. Okay, quick update. This is Monday morning now, day three, and Will's had a, how big is it, Will?
28.6
common, first fish of the trip. Pete's leading the way at the minute. He's had four up to £50.10, so I'll give you a full update later on, but I just wanted to come round and catch this one. So see another lovely Beauregard fish there, so well done, mate.
Happy days. Once I've got the weight in, I'm fine.
Oh, yeah, I'm just score it side. So here we go, this is an update on Tuesday morning, and we've got Will, and Will's on a mirror last night, another PB. How big's that one, Will?
Oh, Christ, I can't even remember.
46.10.
46.10.
Excellent, just keep it there, mate. I'll just take some stills on this one.
God, it's a lump, isn't it, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Bloody hell.
That's it, keep staying there, mate. One sec.
How you picked that 65 up, I'll never know.
Just have a look at the camera, mate. That's one more. You alright for a minute here?
Yeah. What the hell?
That's what we come for.
Whew. It's getting heavy now, mate. We all done.
Yeah, just one sec, let's just come in. Yeah, excellent, mate. Go on, drop it down. So, this is the next update for our Beauregard video diary. It's Tuesday morning now. As you can see from behind me, from the previous one that I did, I've changed swims yesterday. I started off in peg 1. Did Saturday night in there and Sunday night in there, and I just couldn't see a fish, to be honest with you. I couldn't see anything, so I saw a few fish in front of this. This is peg 12 I'm on now, so I moved all my gear down yesterday morning. Got set up by yesterday afternoon, put my rods out yesterday evening after tea. Haven't had anything through the night. Typical really, as I've moved in, the fish seem to have stopped showing as much, but you know, I'm feeling more confident. It's slightly deeper water. Got a pretty cold week this week. We've had sort of 9-10 degrees as the highest temperature in the day, and we've been getting 0 and -1 at night. So, you know, it's been a bit of a downturn in the weather, which I think has knocked it. But update on the fish, and so far I still haven't had anything. I had a little 3-pound catfish yesterday as I was reeling in. On the carp front, Pete, who's fishing peg 10, has had 5 now. Biggest being £50.10. Will, who is in peg 11 next to him, I videoed him yesterday with the 28, and I've just done another bit of footage that you'll see, or will have already seen, should I say, and that was 46.10, so that's a PB for him, so that's two PBs done this week. Eamon, that's fishing down in peg 6, he hasn't had anything as of yet, but he may have had something last night that we've not had an update on, and we'll get that at breakfast. Steve, who's in peg 3, which is sort of just behind me over my left shoulder, he's had a 28 and lost one. And Goldie, who's in peg 4, he had a mirror about 9 o'clock last night, but I'm not too sure what the weight of that was, so I'll find that out this morning. As far as I mentioned in the first update that I did, that I was going to pick up some bait from a guy in Milton Keynes, or just outside Milton Keynes, should I say, Wellingborough, from XL Baits. And the VNF that we got from here, Vanilla Nut Fudge, is the one that's really doing the business so far. That's what's... Will's had his 46.10 on it, and Pete's had his 50 on it. So, you know, I've got two rods on it now. And that seems to be the one that's doing the business, which is what Sean, who owns the company at XL, he said that when I picked the bait up, he would expect the VNF to be the one that did the fish over in France, because it's got a bit of an instant appeal sort of success rate to it. So I will go through the bait at some point through the rest of the week, and I'll talk a bit more about the lake. I'll have a wander around and film some of the pegs. But yeah, on the fish front, up to now we've had 5, 7, 8 fish out between the group, which considering the conditions isn't bad going, but they're certainly not feeding heavily. They're just picking up the odd bit. So going to reel in shortly and go and prep breakfast, and then I'll give you another update later on today. Okay, cheers. Yeah, okay.
There you go.
Yeah, so latest update. This is my third peg of the week now, peg 6. Eamon's moved out this morning and gone down to 1 where I started off, because the fish had moved in there, and I had a little walk up here this morning. Spotted a few fish in the margin, so I've been down here probably 2 hours now fishing, and I've just managed to get to on a mirror 30 pound 10 ounce. I'll just hold it up and let you have a little look.
Come on, girl.
There we go. You got that, mate?
Mm-hmm. All in.
Yeah.
Yep.
Happy days, two little 10 mil hybrid and a piece of plastic corn. Lovely. Okay, mate.
Are you ready?
So here we go. This is Wednesday morning, late Beauregard. Eamon that's dropped down into peg 1. Oh. Take your time, mate. It's managed to pick up. How big was it, Eamon?
51 pound 2 ounce
mirror. That's the second 50 of the week for us. He's just going to pick it up for the camera and let you have a look. Just keep it up there, mate, while I just do a few stills on this one. You alright for a second?
Yeah. Should have gone to the gym before I started this lark, though.
That's it, mate. One more, mate, and then we'll be done.
Sorry, boys, it's going to have to go.
Well done, mate.
Well done, fella.
Right, so here we go, this is the same fish. This is Eamon's 51 pound mirror. We're just getting some shots of him with it in the water.
Whee, yeah, she's gone.
And that's one way of releasing him.
Catch and release.
Well done, mate. New PB, Eamon. Good man.
How to put a...
So here we go, next update, pretty sharp, pretty quick after the last one. Just had a 51 mirror, and here we go, Eamon's just had this, which is a 55 common. What was your PB before your 51, Eamon?
37,
so you smashed it twice in the space of half an hour. Wednesday morning, happy days, well done, mate, excellent.
Thank you, boys, thank you, fish. Thank you.
Right, so here we go, this is Eamon again with his 55 common, just come down to the water to get some more shots of it. Look at that, absolutely stunner of a fish. Excellent. Well done, mate, just drop it back in the mat for a minute. Excellent, well done, mate. Okay, so next update from Beauregard. This is still Wednesday afternoon now, and Will's just had a daytime mirror. What weight was it, Will?
34.8,
absolutely stunning fish you can see there again. That's it, mate. Lovely. Okay, just drop it down, mate. Okay, so Will's just going to show us the other side of the fish. It's got quite a distinctive scale on it, so it's worth having a look at this one for future reference.
Behaving itself for you, isn't it?
Yeah. Beauty.
Excellent, mate. Well done. What did you get that one on, mate? Was it an XL VNF again?
VNF again.
Doing the business.
Job, mate. Doing the job.
That done all your fish this week?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Beautiful.
Good stuff. Well done, mate.
Thank you.
Okay, so we're just going to watch this one of Will's going around. This is the mirror that we've just had a shot of. We're just going to film him putting it back. Absolutely stunning fish, that one. There he goes.
Hey. Fantastic.
Off into the depths. Excellent. Well done, mate. So, here we go. This is the next update from Lake Beauregard. It's now Thursday afternoon. I'm fishing my third peg of the week. I've moved again today. So just a quick update on how my week's gone so far. Came out 6 out of 6 in the draw. Wasn't really a major problem because, you know, we've put 7 pegs into the draw and 6 of them I'd happily fish, and the spare one I'd quite happily fish anyway. So chose peg 1. There was a northerly breeze blowing into it, but it wasn't a major concern. Fished that Saturday afternoon, Sunday, till Monday morning, and I just didn't see a fish. There was nothing bubbling, there was nothing rolling. I couldn't see anything, so I'd had a bit of a walk round. The water was quite clouded up in front of peg 12, which was the spare one, the 7th peg that no one was fishing. So I moved down to there on Monday, lunchtime. Fished Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday in there. On Monday afternoon, the wind changed to a southerly wind, which I thought would be pretty, you know, a bit of a bonus really, but it was a freezing cold southerly wind. It also came with some hail storms. We've had rain, we've had frost. High temperatures in the day have been 8 degrees, 9 degrees, and at night it's been going to -1, so it's not really been great for fishing. But I did till today in there. I didn't see a fish. I climbed up a tree today, had a look in the bay that I was fishing in, and I just couldn't see anything. So packed up my gear again. I've moved up to peg 6 now. Ironically, Eamon started off in peg 6, this peg I've come into. He fished Saturday, Sunday and Monday, and didn't have a bite in here. Didn't have a bleep, didn't see anything. But Monday night, after I'd moved, the spots I'd been feeding in peg 1, I noticed they were starting to cloud up a little bit. And then Tuesday morning, they'd really clouded the bay up. So Eamon asked if I minded if he moved down into that, which I'd only gone into peg 12, so it's fair game. He moved down into peg 1. And then Wednesday morning, he had a 51-4 mirror and a 55 dead common within half an hour of each other. So it just shows, you know, you've got to move, you've got to follow the fish, and it's, you know, there's absolutely no bitterness. I know I started off in there, but I moved out, got it wrong really, and he moved in, and he's reaped the rewards. He was absolutely over the moon. He smashed his PB, so yeah, I was really made up for him. Good angling as far as I'm concerned. So I've come down to 6 since I've been here. I've seen in this channel that's behind me, I have fished this peg twice before. I've seen 4 or 5 fish roll. I've had a couple of liners. I've only been fishing for an hour, so I've fished peg 12 and I didn't see a fish for 3 days. So I did manage to nick one out of this peg on, I think it was Tuesday. That was £30.10. Well, let's see. Hopefully I'll get one tonight or overnight. You know, there is plenty of fish down there, so I'm confident I'll get one. And I've seen them also on the spot that's sort of to my left hand side as I look out at the lake, on the same spot that I nicked one from the other day. So I've got fish in both areas of the swim, so I'm confident I'll get one this evening at some point. Just a quick update, the weather's been okay today. It's probably been 14 degrees, the sun's been out, and the reason I'm sort of wrapped up like this is because I put my chair here where I'm sat now to do the update, looking out over the lake. As I sat down on the chair, the legs collapsed. I did a backward roll and ended up in the margin, completely submerged. So that's why I'm wrapped up, because it was a bit chilly really, and I'm still soaking wet now, but I wanted to do an update. This is my first attempt, like I'd said earlier in the diary, first attempt at doing one, and I haven't really done as much recording as I'd wanted to. But to be honest with you, with the rain that we've had, really, really sort of bad conditions, I suppose. I've been moving peg and then packing up and moving again, and I just haven't had time. I have managed to get some of the lads fish on the update, so at least you can see
see the quality of the fish in this place, and you know, hopefully you'll enjoy watching that. With regards to the bait, I am going to do an update on XL baits tomorrow, but I'll continue with that tomorrow because I want to get the range that they've got and just tell you a bit more about it. I'm going to switch off now because sounds like a tractor just coming past. So yeah, if I get any fish, I'll do another update, but if not, I'll speak to you tomorrow. Cheers.
Okay, so this is Thursday evening, Lake Beauregard. We've just had our tea and Pete managed to nick this one before we went down for tea, so he's just going to hold it up and let you have a look at it. Just one sec, let me just come in a bit closer, mate. Get it. Look at it, stunning mirror, that one. Just one sec, mate. Yeah, there we go. How big was that one, mate?
31.5 pound.
31.5, what'd you get it on?
XL's VNF pop-up.
Single pop-up?
Single pop-up, 16 mil.
Excellent. Good stuff, mate. Happy days. Right, so here we go. This is a Friday morning, Lake Beauregard. Absolutely cracking night fishing last night. Warmed up a bit yesterday and we ended up getting 350s during the night. And this is the first one that Goldie's caught. What weight is it, mate?
52.8.
52.8 common. What was your PB before that?
37.10.
37.10, so he's absolutely smashed it. I'll just zoom in on that, mate. Perfect, look at that. First one of the three that we've got. We'll do some more shots of them all together, but well done, mate. Excellent fish, that.
Anywhere near it, fellas.
Right, so here we go. This is the second one of the 50s that came out last night, Lake Beauregard again. And this is Pete. What was the weight, Pete?
59 dead.
59 dead, mirror.
VNF.
What was your PB before that, mate?
56.
So, and that was this week as well, so you've done two PBs in a week. Look at that, absolutely stunning fish. I'll just zoom in, mate, get a closer look at it.
Okay, so this is the third of the 50s that came out last night, Lake Beauregard again. New PB for me, it's a 56 pound common. Caught it on a single 16 mil XL baits VNF. Put the rod out 45 minutes later, it went off, so I'll just hold it up for you now and then we'll get some stills. Just leave it on, mate, and I'll just well.
Right, okay, so Friday morning, Lake Beauregard again. Just doing the pictures and the weights of them 350s that we've had overnight, and Eamon, who's fishing in the next peg down, his rod's rattled off and he's now got, how big is it, Eamon?
39.2.
Yep. Excellent. Just keep it there for a sec, mate, and I'll just zoom in so everyone can get a better look. A little dumpy football on that one.
Yep.
Happy days, mate. What did you catch that one on, mate?
That was on a bit of maize.
Single bit of maize.
Okay, so Lake Beauregard, these are the 350s that we had last night. We've got a 56, a 59, and what's your one's, Goldie?
52.8.
Just hook it back on, boys. Go on, jot yours down, mate.
Nice. Playing ball, my one.
Oh, I'm just dropping down a bit. It's fucking killing me. Still recording. Yeah, so we had two of these on the VNF, XL baits VNF, the 56 and the 59, and Goldie's, what were yours on, mate?
Popped up tiger.
Popped up tiger nut, so there we go. Yeah, one more shot for the camera. Okay. Okay, so last shots of these three £50 fish, 56, 59 and 52.8. There we go. Beautiful, three absolutely stunning fish.
XL baits.
XL baits and
tiger nuts.
Tiger nuts.
Tiger nuts.
Excellent, well done fellas. Right, let's do a still, mate. Lake Beauregard again. This is Friday afternoon. Latest update, went to the supermarket after we took them pictures of them 350s before. Came back, been back in my swim for probably 2 hours. I've had two fish in the last 2 hours. I've got a 4610 in the sling that I'm going to do some footage of after. And then I've just had this one, and Pete's come round to take some pictures for me. So this is 31-4, little mirror. Okay, so I'm just going to hoist it up and let you have a look at it, and then we'll get some stills. Yeah, is it still recording, mate? Yeah, another one. So this came off my margin rod, and another one on the 16mm XL Baits VNF. Absolutely cracking bait. It's really done some good fishing. I'm going to do a bit of a feature after on the bait, but just wanted to show you the fish. Cheers.
Okay, so this is the update on the bait range that we've been using this week that I've said I was going to do a couple of times during the week. So this is XL Baits. They're based in Wellingborough in the Midlands, and they do two different baits, VNF and KSC, that you can see there. I've just put a selection of the products that we bought with us. I've got two bags there, VNF and KSC, 5 kilo bags of 14mm freezer bait. They do a food source stick and bag mix as well. Got a couple of tubs of pop-ups in there and a liquid as well. You can get that all in both the ranges. They do some fluoros as well in different sizes. Sean, who owns the company, he's been making bait for over 10 years. And to be honest with you, I've used quite a lot of different sort of small producers of bait, and this is the only stuff that I would actually sort of recommend to anybody. This week it's definitely outfished anything else that we've used. There's been three of us on it. We've had 14 fish between us, and 11 of the fish have come on the VNF. Sean, again, when I picked up the bait from him, he spoke to me and he said that out of the two baits, VNF's the one that's, they've had a good track record of instant success. The KSC is more of a session bait, so if you're looking to do a season or a couple of seasons on a water, that's the one to go on. But absolutely brilliant stuff, and if you get in contact with him, let him know that you've seen it. He'll do you a decent deal, and he'll certainly cater for anything that you want, any sizes, any amounts, and or you know, your extras, pop-ups, fluoro pop-ups, liquids or stick mixes. Really good stuff.
Recording.
Okay, so Lake Beauregard. This is the one that I mentioned on earlier when I showed you the 30. This was the first one of the two I got. £46.10. Common carp again on a single 16mm XL Baits VNF. Absolutely cracking bait for us this week. So I'm just going to let you have a quick look at him, because he's been a bit lively. He's been in the sling for a little while. Okay, mate, yeah?
Lovely jubbly.
Okay, so this is a Saturday morning. Last morning we're on the pack down now at Lake Beauregard. I've managed to nick two more fish this morning, so that's taken my total up to 6 for the week. I've had 4 in the last 24 hours, so it's sort of turned around the session for me, really. First one's 25. I'll show you that one first, and then I'll get the one out that's slightly bigger and show you that one after. Again, both of them come to a single 14mm XL bait VNF. I'll be a bit lively because he's been in the sling, so. Come on, let's have a look at you.
a goal in a minute. And there we go, there's the first one, that's the mirror. £25 on the nose. Okay.
Happy days.
Okay, so this is the second one of the two that I've had this morning. £33.10 common, my last fish of the trip. Again, single 14mm XL bait V&F. Fish just in the channel behind me. So just have a little look at him. Okay.
So here we go, this is the I'm back home in my garage, back where the video diary started last Friday, and a bit of a rushed intro that I did before I headed off to Milton Keynes. So up at 4 o'clock this morning because I had a fish, got back to bed, had another fish at 6 o'clock, and then I was up, packed down my stuff, we left about 9:30, travelled up to Calais, back to Milton Keynes, picked up my van, just got back up to Manchester now, and just unloaded all my stuff into the garage. So just to give you a quick rundown on how the week went for us. Total we had 28 fish between the group, which I was banking on about 15 really at the start of the week based on the conditions. Yeah, 28 fish. We had 6 50s, 2 40s, 11 30s and 9 20s, which really for the conditions is phenomenal fishing. And to get 3 of the 50s like you've seen all at the same time, pretty much, is just a dream fishing, really. I did a PB, 56 common. Pete did a PB, 59 mirror. Goldie did a PB, that was 52 common. Will did a PB, that was a 46 mirror. Eamon did a PB, which was a 51 common. 51 mirror, and then he caught a 55 common half an hour later. So just unbelievable fishing. Like Beauregard. So massive thanks to Roger and Sarah. Facilities absolutely spotless, lake was stunning as it always is, you know, just lovely to drive round. Pegs are immaculate, couldn't ask for any more. He knows his lake inside out, he'll put you onto the spots, he'll tell you what to do if he thinks you're not doing something right, he'll leave you alone if that's what you want. But he's a great guy. We had a bit of a mains electricity problem due to the power company doing some work. I rang him up, he came straight down, sorted it out that night, done, no problem, power was back on. So they're the kind of things that you look for when you're going to a venue and you're there for a week, really. Just a little note with regards to the hat that I've got on, but I suppose you've probably noticed it, I've had it on in virtually every update that I've done. Well, my granddad's Irish, and when I was about 9, I suppose I wasn't into carp fishing then, I was fishing on the River Trent really, but he gave me this hat and said make sure that I take it fishing with me wherever I go because it'll be my lucky hat. I've took it obviously at the time when I was 9, it was far too big for me. I've taken it everywhere since, and you'll see from the photographs and the footage that I do that, you know, it really has been a lucky omen for me, and I've certainly had my best fishing whenever I've had it with me. So a bit of superstition I guess, but it works for me. So and again, as I said at the start of the video, that's what carp fishing's about. I've had a great time this week. The lads have been an absolute screen to be with. Really, really fantastic. I know I've banged on about it, but XL baits, check them out on the internet. V&F, absolutely outfished everything this week. The first time I've used it, I didn't know about the company until Pete put me onto it. I went and met Sean in a Tesco car park before we went down there. He came out of his way to get me the bait on time. Two different sizes, I took 14mm, Pete took 18s, Pete had fluoros, we both had pop-ups, and I've just got to say that, you know, the V&F just absolutely outfished everything. It's an absolutely brilliant bait, lovely and nutty, bit of cream from the vanilla, and then the fudge sweetness in it is just fantastic. So have a look. They also do the krill one, just to get on the internet and have a look at him, contact Sean and he'll sort you out, no problem. Well, I suppose that's it really. I don't know when my next video diary is going to be. I think I did mention it at the start of the week, but just in case I didn't, I forgot really, it's been a long week. I have started up a Facebook page, a Twitter account and a YouTube account called Carp Bible, so check me out. Some good stuff on there. I've got quite a few lakes following me, other anglers who have got mad interest in carp, which is what it's all about. There's some bait companies following me, might be local to your area, give them a try, forward on their stuff. Share your own stuff on it, Facebook, that's what I want it to be about, what you've cooked on the bank, fish that you've caught, lakes that you've been to. I just want people that are as passionate as I am about carp fishing, sharing information, sharing experiences with each other, you know, and just have it, we all go out for the same objective, and that's to catch immense carp and have a good time on our own or with our mates and family. And for me, this is what the carp experiences are all about. So check it out, like the Facebook page, follow me on Twitter. I'll be posting this video on there on the YouTube account, and hopefully I can do. I've got a lot of work commitments, so whether I'll get any more done this year, hopefully I will. But if you like it, tell me you like it. If you didn't like it, tell me it was boring and you think I should have done a bit more on rigs or what have you. But I've just really wanted to cover the fish that we've caught, done a couple of updates, and this is the end of the diary. So hopefully see you soon. Hopefully this will come out well, and if you like it, keep an eye on Carp Bible stuff. And I'll keep loads of information coming to you. Okay, cheers.
It's time.